Good afternoon. In this lesson, we will learn how to deal with the Excavator's app interface. So let's start. Let's head to the web page you're interested in and press the extension icon at the top right hand corner of the screen. Now press Start Excavator and wait until the app starts running. Now you can see Excavator app interface. So what do we have here? Let's start with tabs at the top part of the opened window. The first tab is Builder. It automatically opens when the app is started. Other tabs that you can see are View Code, Diggers Stroke Settings, and Tutorials. Let's take a look at these for a while and return to the Builder options later. View Code. Here you can find generated scripts for the Diggernaut.com service. You can examine this script and also copy it. Digger Stroke Settings provides an interface for digger editing and management. You need to write your API key before you can use it. You will also see a list of created diggers which show essential information. These are filed under project. You can download these scripts in Excavator as well as make any required changes. Now let's return to Builder and take a closer look. The Builder window is divided into two parts: web page and control interface. Let's start by taking a look at the web page part. Don't be worried if the website's overview differs from the default browsers. It's because JavaScript's execution is switched off. Move your cursor inside the left window. You will see different blocks are highlighted as you move the cursor. Left mouse click and the highlighted block will show the selection in the inspector section on the page. Clicking on an empty square icon selects the parent block and makes it the main one. This means you can click on a parent block icon until you find the required block. This is useful if you can't select the necessary block due to the web page design. Now take a look at the right side of the screen. The first thing you'll notice is a switcher with a CSS sign on it. Go ahead and click it. The switcher toggles CSS styles on and off this page. You'll see the results in real time. Even when switched off, the styles continue to work. The next button is Save. It allows you to save the current script in your account to the Diggernaut.com website. Let's take a closer look at this option. Once you press the Save button, some further options are displayed. From here, you can select the project where you want the digger saved. Once selected, enter a name for the digger and a URL. Once you press the Save button, all details are saved to your chosen project. If you receive any errors when saving, the system will display information on these. There is also an option to replace an existing saved config with a new version. You will see another option on the Save menu: replace existing digger config with this digger config. Selected this option will overwrite the existing config saved for this digger. Let's now take a look at the list of commands for the script. There are various commands and options, each of which we will explore during future lessons. For now, I'll explain how to add commands to the scripts with some general background information. The commands find and find all are only available in the inspector. In order to use the commands, you need to place your cursor on the three striped icon. Press and hold the left mouse button and drag an element to the block we are working with. Available areas where the command can be inserted will be highlighted in green. Let's add all possible commands to the script and examine their interface. While working with a script, you will notice commands start to take more and more space. That's why most commands can be folded and expanded by double clicking on the left mouse button. Also, most of the commands have a field for data input and pop-out menus for additional options. Some of them have special buttons that add new fields, for example, filters and regular expressions. You can delete these fields using the delete button. Some commands have a preview button. Clicking it opens a slider that displays registers content that has already been modified after performing this command. You can expand the slider's size and close it if you don't need it anymore. You can easily reorder these commands within the block. Just click and drag the three striped icon on the command and move it to the required place. Nearly all commands can be deleted by simply pressing the cross at the top right corner of the commands block. And finally, all commands, walk and find, can be folded with a special button. That's us finished with the interface description. See you all at the next lesson.